So hello, day 9 in the life of a little mulberry caterpillar. We will see what they do today. I was a little bit lazy also with this caterpillars because I was very busy, so I couldn't change a lot of material, but only quickly. Today I have to really make some new settings for them with these two new plastic dishes, and we have a look what they do underneath here. What we clearly see is that they already are in the L2 stage. Where we see that? Yeah, here, express. They have grown, of course, and quickly now they have come up from the bottom of these leaves to the top. We'll see that later, before I prepare my two new places where they can live with the same setting as for the last one, just on the bottom, little paper that is a little wet so that they don't dry out, and also the leaves that they eat, that the food material is not drying out too fast. But I say only 2 drops or three drops. Because now it's starting to be colder in Switzerland. Temperatures in the night go down to 6 degrees. So if we are heating inside the house, the humidity goes slightly down. So you have to think about that. That now we should take care for the humidity. Here's another beautiful leaf that I just cut in some pieces to put the caterpillars on, like this, and then I will have a look what they are actually doing now here, because I think if we take up these leaves here, we can see a lot of caterpillars underneath. Yes, that's the truth. Look here, it's all covered with nice big caterpillars of Bombyx mori. All, everything is here. And what I do, I just put, I can use another one like this here. Also, it is here. Let's see what we find when we take it up a little bit. Also here we find some. This we can just cut out like this and put it back here. Also here the whole leaf is covered with this caterpillars of Bombyx mori. Yeah, very nice. They grow beautifully here. This one, typical. All the caterpillars looking for some new food. And of course, the leaf that is here, you see how it's eaten up already by the caterpillars completely. They make little holes in the leaf. So normally caterpillars, they go to the end of the leaf and start eating there, but not in these two stages of the mulberry silkworm. They just start eating the leaf, but they let the ribs here, like you see. They don't eat it because it's too hard for them to chow. And also this one here, I have to pay attention that I don't cut one of it. So, because now let's see how many of them I can bring through this next 40 days that they should leave, because now I don't have so many leaves anymore. Outside there are some little mulberry trees waiting. And of course, if they are getting bigger, they start eating more. And in the end phase, I have to call my friends from the Swiss Silk Organization to help me out, probably with some mulberry leaves. Otherwise, probably I have not enough food. And I have to try, as I told you already, this artificial food made with powdered mulberry and agar-agar. Also, of course, we can later try to make our own recipe with this kind of food. But for the moment, at the moment now, we just make it like this. You can cover dishes slightly. Of course, they should not be completely covered, because a little air exchange is always good, but this is not a problem if you just put the dish on it like this, and then we wait for another 2 days and see what happens. Thank you for watching.